In this video I will demonstrate how to create and use compounds to coordinate the movement of different parts. We have a placer for the red cube. And one for the yellow cube. Okay, and the next what we want to do is movement for the underlying button. This one, the placer for the button. So, and I set this to 0 and I say I only want to have a rotation target as the button object. Okay, and in this case when I run this one I have this rotation. Okay, and I move the placer into the manager hierarchy, and now I can run all together. And now we have the problem that the bottom rotates here, but the movement of the yellow cube is in absolute x direction here from top view. And what I want to have is an animation where the yellow cube goes always on top of the bottom object. So let's go back to initial station. And so what I do now is I create a compound of the bottom, the red cube and the yellow cube. Compounds, there is a submenu compounds, create compound of the selection. This is the same method as the compound of the part workbench. And now I can add a placer, and this placer should have as target the compound. Okay, and here is 0. And now I can run it, and I see all three parts are rotated this way. Go back to 0. So, and now I move this placer for the compound here inside the manager. I rename it. This is the compound placer. So, and I hide the button placer. That means now I have a movement of the compound, and I have these two placements for the red and the yellow cube. And now I start the manager, and now we see when we start the manager, the yellow cube is always on top of the bottom, and also the red cube is above it. Let's switch to the view from top. So, and now we see we have a composition of all these movements. That means I can use a compound to get a placement hierarchy. Okay, stop. Next thing what is useful is to have other objects inside the compound. We have here a torus, and I say I want to move the torus to here. So, and now I can say that I want that the torus is inside the compound. Add selection to the compound. So the torus is inside, and when I run I see the torus is changed. Stop. And I always can change the position of this object and rerun. And so I see now the new relative position of the torus is used in this case. Two. So. Okay, once more I use the torus from here and I move it. Oh. Torus. Here. Okay, the problem is I have to go back to the initial station and then I have to move it from here to the endpoint. And voila, now the torus of the compound rotates with the compound and this is the original torus. And I can do the same with another object. I can say I use the sphere, which is here. I move the sphere from here to nearly the middle. I put it here. And now I add the sphere to the compound and run. And now we see the sphere also rotates in the same way. And we also can delete something inside the compound. Say I do not want to move the torus anymore with the compound. I select these two ones and I say compounds delete selection from compound. Then the torus is outside the compound and okay. It's here still. And I run and now I see the sphere is rotated with the compound. And the torus rests here on this position.